World War II and another day of Allied bombing above Naples. Another race by terrified residents down into the underground air raid shelters. While outside a firestorm of destruction was beginning, the bowels of Naples silently welcomed its children. Precious little evidence remains today of those frightening hours spent huddled in the deep caverns, frozen moments of life spent praying, hoping to survive the destruction raining down from above. Bits and pieces of anomalous lives made real by a few scattered artifacts, ceramic insulators from the emergency lighting system, a child's ball, and shards of big clay water jugs. And here, an old Singer sewing machine left behind, perhaps used by some dressmaker to pass time, or simply to not fall behind in her work. Ornate majolica tiles from some bombed-out home above. Old printing plates used to print labels for cans of tomatoes or jars of marmalade, or even playing cards. All lined up on one of the long stone seating areas dug into the walls of old early Neapolitan cisterns in the more comfortable air raid shelters for people to have a place to sit as they waited out the bombing raid above. Someone decided to leave their thoughts, a snapshot of their soul. Their feelings, graffiti that still today tell us about those long uncertain days spent underground. Some entrances and passageways in these air raid shelters, hastily dug down into the existing ancient sandstone quarries, were not completed. You can still see the roughed-in plans for additional access stairwells. But there wasn't time for the Neapolitans to finish such work anyway, with the deafening, building-leveling explosions above, which down in the depths below the city, heard and felt only as dull thuds and faint shudders of the earth. They're sealed off stairwells to nowhere today, descending into total pitch black darkness. Yet loving Mother Earth still remains, always ready to receive with open arms those who instead have forgotten about her, and who will forget about her again.